Yeah, good afternoon again. This is Dr. George from Scholastico System. Today's lesson on academic skills and study confidence. Course number BMM 3113 is gonna be on. I can just show the slide. Will be on the just before going this slide, like I said, as always, with academic skills and studying with confidence, we want to know the objectives of the course that we are taking. Just gonna share it to you again. Just slides on my board. Just need to show just 1 second. Okay, so today we're going to be looking at communication skills for essay writing and report. That's what we're going to be looking at. We're going to be looking at essay communication skills for essay writing and also report for today. But one thing first that I want us to look at for the academic skills, like I always say, is what is expected of us in this course. In this course, like we discussed the last time, what is expected of us in this course? We discussed that is expected of us for BMM 3113. What is expected of us in this course? For BMM 113, to do a literature review for 1,500 words, giving out the topics before. Out of 10 topics, we look at the 10 topics. And then from the 10 topics, we look at the structure of how we need to set up our writing. Cover page, table of content, introduction, aims and objective, literature, the main literature review, and conclusion with reference. And then the second part of past of the assignment of this course is presentation, group presentation, 4 to 5 people in a group, and then with presentation slides to be presented for 15 minutes for that group, 12 to 15 minutes for every group. So this is the structure again. We have the first slide where we have the names and the title of the presentation, introduction. We have definitions. We have the reason that we are doing that particular topic, which is a why, the do's and the don'ts of that particular topic. We have the styles or the type of that particular topic, and we have the examples of that particular topic in slides. Remember, they are in slides, PowerPoint presentation. And then we also have conclusion and your reference list. Okay, so let's make sure we have all of that in our slides, PowerPoint slides, and then I'll meet up with part, the structural part of the presentation. So like I said, today's topic is on communication in essay writing and reporting. So let's go to the slides for today's discussion. Let's go to the slide for today's discussion. Like I said, today's slides, for today's discussion, I can just put this one on the board. Doesn't look like, I think we have too many slides on this one. It's communication skills for essay and report writing. First thing that I wanted to ask to the classes, what is communication? There's a difference between communication and actually talking. Communication is actually, if you can, anybody in the class can answer what communication and talking, you can just think about it. See, what is the difference? Dr. George is asking what is the difference between talking and communication skills. So what do we need to know in terms of communication? Okay, so if you can just think about that for like few seconds, and then I'll ask you, you'll be able to give me some examples of what you think talking and communication is, that'll be a good thing. Okay, the next one is that we have to now think about the basic steps of writing an academic essay. We have to think about what are the basic steps? This, which is part of communication anyway, because that's the communicative skills that we're talking about. Now, what are the basic steps that we need to consider when we're writing about academic essay? The one thing is that the topic that we are talking about, we need to have an understanding of that topic. And the only way that we can have an understanding of that topic is to read various type of literature concerning that particular topic. And how do we find this literature? By utilizing internet resources. Internet resources, if we can go to, say, for example, a Google Scholar, we'll be able to type the part of a particular topic that we're looking for. We're going to type it in Google Scholar, and you will see that we bring out a whole bunch of a whole lot of a lot of information based on that particular topic. And always in terms of getting that information, it is important that we take notes. Notes taking is important. The reason that we should take notes, especially in class, when the teacher, like as I'm speaking to you now, you should have your paper and a book where you are writing this information, taking notes. Because what does it do? It is knowledge, the knowledge that you have acquired or that you've learned in the class. Okay. The other thing about having a basic understanding in to write an academic essay is when it's for you to just develop, helps you to develop a good understanding of the topic. Then you must, one must then first analyze towards, one must develop the steps in analyzing your research, and also to know the good points and the bad point of that particular research that you're embarking on. And that one is very important. The other thing that we also need to be aware of with step four, that you need to start to put your own initiative in every writing. And there needs to be an understanding, aspect of that particular piece of work that you're doing, that you put your own initiative or your own understanding in that piece of writing. Questions and answers in return with regards to the literature, and again to answer all those questions. And the other thing about it is that when you have developed a clear understanding of the topic in question, then you have to now learn how to structure and report your essay. How to structure your report or how to structure your essay. These ones are also very important. That's the step five. And the essay or the report structure, how does the essay and the report structure look like? Just like as I was showing you the 1,500 words of literature review, we had the structure for it. For every writing, there's a structure. So we need to adhere to that structure. Follow it. Follow the structure. And if you follow the structure, and you have a great opportunity or great advantage of succeeding in that particular piece of writing. So, for every essay or report structure, we need to have it in this form. Number one, introduction. We'll talk about the introduction, basically introducing what you're talking about. And then we'll talk about the main body. Main body talks about the things that you have introduced. You're not highlighting, you're not now, extrapolating information based on those things that you have introduced. You're now writing more information on them. And then that will make up your main body. And then if in the case of a literature review, after you have done the reading and you have found out the basic various conclusions, have realigned them, and then you have a recommendation based on the gaps or the gaps that you found as a result of your research, then you will now give those recommendations based on the gaps that you found and how to cover those gaps. And also, after we've done that, then there's this aspect of actually concluding based on everything that you have done. Then we just kind of focus on the main things that we have found out. And then the number five thing that we should also do is to focus on referencing. There's no academic writing that you'll be able to showcase without reference. Reference shows that you actually done your work, an academic piece of work, because you've related to other people that have written about that topic to back your what you are saying. Because they're actually the ones that are actually giving you the ideas, and those ideas, you are putting them together, according to your knowledge, to be able to bring it back to life again, where people can look at it and be able to say you have done well. Okay. And then the other thing, skills, communication skills for academic writing. How many times must you read your assignment brief? In this case, with your assignment brief, there's, like we said, there is a method, there's a way that you have to put together your assignment. And the brief is where you go to find out the information on how to put it together. One, two, three, four, or five times. How many times? I would say you should read it all the time, so that you can be up to date with what you're supposed to, that you don't forget with it, especially with these days of the hustle and bustle of life. Sometimes after you leave school, you forget about what you have done in school. So you should go back, find the time to look at your this the skills, how many times you should read, should look at back at the assignment brief. This assignment brief enables you to be on top of the assignment that is required for a particular course so that you can be up to date, not only up to date, but to do your work, exceptionally, But basic answer on for this particular one is five. Five. Every time you read your, and the, it develops your understanding of the topic. When you do go through your assignment briefs, what does it do? It develops your understanding of that particular topic, or rather the assignment that you're supposed to turn. And the other thing that we should also have in mind, where should we look for secondary data? Because most of the stuff that we look at, they are all secondary data. These are things that the people have done research on. These are primary researchers. They have done research on it and they have got the data. And the data is just kind of a proven data. All you go is to look for them, and then you that is looking for it, you're not extracting it as secondary data based on the information that people, academicians have gotten. Now, where do we get these secondary data? Examples are books, yeah? Books that we get in the library. We have books here in at SSS. You can get books from the library here at SSS. You can get the e-books where you go to the Leeds Trinity University, go to the library, and you can search for all kinds of books in the Leeds Trinity University library. Also, we have academic journals also. You can get those ones. Also, you can also get newspapers, and you can also get published articles. You can also get other authentic sources that we can use in order to aid us in terms of meeting the topic of assignment that we have chosen. And the other topic that we also need to think that we also need to think about is that, you know, when we think about how do we improve our writing skills, how do we improve our writing skills? We have different rules that we need to engage in order to improve our writing skills. First rule says that you have to write, read, and write every day, minimum, the lowest that you can get, not the highest, but the lowest, of 200 words, in a day, 200 words a day. Read and write 200 words a day. Number two, rule two, read relevant topics to your course. Rule three, write simple and short sentences. Rule four, do not use filler words, e.g., that, very, just, etc. Rule five, give your teacher to read and to get feedback to see whether you are doing the right thing. That's very important. Always get your instructors or your lecturers involved in your writing. So in the process, by the time you finished it, you will not have to do a whole lot of going back and forth, basically, because you've been doing it step by step. That's very important. Let's take that on board. And then also, how to improve presentation skills. You know, as we talked about, part of this course, academic skills, studying with confidence, is that we need to have some presentation skills in order to be able to do a group presentation. We need presentation skills. And some of the rules that we need to engage in order to be doing good presentations, so to improve our presentation, is to make it clear, make our presentation clear, make it readable, and next, to whatever we are personal, we need to have clear message, okay? There needs to be a good flow of the information that we are passing on. There needs to be a good color for slides, and the font size needs to be well, this needs to be very well properly done. Do not include too much information on the slide. Like you see some slide presentation slide, too much information on the slide, and that makes you lose marks. So let's make sure they are more like bullet points, and the bullet points that each and every one of us, as we are doing the presentation, we can explain. Let it be that. And then also, like we also said, activity. We also need an activity. We need for this course, we're going to definitely do an activity, essay, academic essay on the scope of marketing plan. For this essay, students are individually required to map a structure for this essay. Like we've already given a structure for this type of like the literature review. So I think the structure will suffice for, especially for academic skills and studying with confidence. And then also let's not forget, after every of our writing, we should have a reference list that makes our work more credible, and that we have done a great job of looking for information to put our work together. Basically, I think that will suffice for this lesson. And in terms of communication skills for report writing and for essays. Thank you for being part of this lecture. I hope that we have done good justice in terms of presenting this information to you. Thank you very much for listening. I'll speak to you again soon, Dr. George. Have a great day. Bye-bye.